first movement of the sonata in the sonata form, use the structure of sonata form, which I'm sure you're aware of, and base your musical choices on that. So in a way, every sonata form tells a story. It tells a story of where we are, where we're going, where we should be and we're not, and how to get our way back home, and then what happens, and so on and so forth. And I think that can just give you so many ideas as to what kind of character we can be on. For example, if we're lost in the development, we need to get out, or if there's a forte passage in the wrong key in the development where we're not yet where we should be, so it kind of limits your choices a little bit more, and it makes them at the same time, by limiting them, it makes them even more, even stronger and more committed. I thought that the small details were fantastic. I mean, you give character to every dot, every wedge, every carrot, every celery stick, anything, every slur, everything, it's great. But the bigger picture, I think, was could be clear, and that's, you know, the structure of the sonata. And sometimes the harmony, you know, when you have a tense harmony, a dominant, going to a tonic, and you have a choice whether play that a little, with a little more energy or less, then a dominant should always have more tension. So that, again, limits your choices and makes them clearer as well. Let's start from the beginning. Character is this? And that's exactly what I'm going to ask you. And of course, it's not one, and it develops, it changes within the crescendo and then the sforzando. But pretend that you've never heard this piece. Nobody has heard it. So we're starting from seven, so you have one note. It doesn't say much. Could say more, but not really. And then until here. Then we have an idea of where we are, right? And once the idea becomes more and more clear in the crescendo, it becomes more convincing, more emphatic, and stronger until there is no doubt where we are there. So can you start not knowing exactly where we are? I mean, the sound should be clear, but don't think so much ahead yet. Okay, so what gives it away to me, the C major, is the E at the end. So if you go there a little bit too quickly, then you give it away a little bit too quickly. Think of the middle of the bar a little bit more. Connect it to the left hand rather than... But if I had to exaggerate, it would be... Still short, but that kind of feeling. Okay. And then this, it's C major finally. It's not C major. So there's a little bit of tension there that gets resolved here. So I think this can be more than that. And then opens up a new phrase. With slurs, it's a different character and different sound. So the same idea goes on later when you have this, for example. sound too similar in articulation and strength, then we're a little bit lost. So Guide Yourself, it doesn't say anything here. There's no crescendo, nothing, really. And if you look, it looks like three lines of the two lines and a half of the same thing. And so Guide Yourself with the harmonic context there. I just wanted to look at the development because it's quite exceptional. So the role of the development is to really wander around to until you get home. It's to look for a way home, it's to look for different colors, different keys. And so the kind of sense in most developments, I mean, from Mozart to, you know, through classical sonatas are actually of feeling things out. They're not so definite, they're not so much of a statement. And your sound can reflect that. You know, you end here in G major, in a big G major, and then the G minor should somehow feel a little bit lost. So, can you start there? Just the last two chords? And make sure that you kind of, at the same time while being lost, you have a plan of where things are. Because you know where you're going, hopefully. So let's see. So when G goes to A, there should be some kind of connection. You're not doing a two-bar phrase and then another two-bar phrase, but G going to E. So in a development, I would definitely connect that. If you have a choice in the development, always connect sections, because you're not starting anything new yet. So start from here now, let's move on from the F major. This fortissimo, the red fortissimo in the middle of the bar, is quite desperate. It's almost, you know, you see something beautiful while he's in F major and he goes there and then he realizes that it's in the wrong place completely. So can you translate that a little bit with your son? That there's really no A flat fundamental here. It's a fake dominant going to a wrong place and realizing that it's in the wrong place. Three 1-bar phrases. So this somehow should feel longer. There it is. rest, if not even longer. Sound strange but not blurry, not too blurry. But I think you can start with just a touch of pedal, so it's not even halfway. And then as you finish here, start lifting already. So that it's not like. Lifting a little bit. Also how you get off the long pedal is very important. It doesn't need to be a very clear cutoff, so that it doesn't sound blurred and not blurred, but just two bars of really feeling very, very lost. There's so much in this development. Let's go on. There's an incredible moment here when he arrives in G major that for a bit that could lead us on, but it doesn't, it goes back to E. And that change should be quite dramatic because it's almost home, but it gets far away even more. So let's try again from there and let's go. This time is upsetting. It's not cute anymore. Yeah? Start from here. I think it can be more fierce. And also because you have, after that, you have piano, then you have pianissimo, and then it's again lost. So the bigger the range, the more effective. This whole section would be. Otherwise, it feels like the development should have ended right here. So make it even more interesting here. Start here and different character. Only piano now. If you played fortissimo before, then you can allow yourself to play not so soft here, so that the pianissimo. Would be very soft. Again, a wrong place. So I think all of this for me is much more turbulent than it should be. Than it is. Have I said something? Or really incredible the way it gets out of it. Just start to play from here and we'll start now. running home already here. And what happens? Now diminuendo. So these three chords of really incredible joy, and then looking around and again, after that silence, it's almost like, hey, I'm home. Yes? So this is the story that I'm just about to tell you. And here is another special place. And in every sonata form, when the second thing comes, when things go wrong, they go different than the exposition. So when the second thing comes in the key of the subject, that's another turning point that you have to highlight for us, so that we know exactly where we are. Okay, great, thank you.